when I talk about your vision, when you talk about your vision, and the church talks about their vision, it's really to fill a need in the community that you're at. Mm-hmm. And I guess the question is, why should we do that? Why should everybody invest their time and money in doing that?
Yes.
Hello,
I'm Ben Johnston, and I've been in this church for more years than I remember. The neighborhood was wonderful. It was a great time in America, I think. I would say that our church and our people, all of our friends, were very affluent, not in the financial sense, but in the important things in life, family, friends, things that we miss so much now because neighborhoods don't exist like that anymore, and that is what has happened to our church.
Well, my name is Mark Puckett, and I was appointed to East Gadsden in June of 2011. And when I arrived at the campus, I realized that we had a lot of issues surrounding us with the community and the fact that it had changed and the church had not changed in almost two decades.
My name is Troy Walker, and I will be taking over as pastor here at East Gadsden on the 17th of June. And here at East Gadsden, we have a vision. And our vision, though it might seem new, it's not very new. It's the same vision that God had when he sent his son to this earth. The same vision that he had for the church to be the church.
Finally, we've come to the conclusion we cannot support. We've been blessed many times. We had a budget with which we approved it on faith. And God, he honored our faith. But we failed him in one way, that we have not gone out and made disciples for him, especially in this neighborhood.
You know, God works great things for all of us. And really, the reality is, it's for his glory.
I love working with kids. I love seeing their learning about God, learning about each other, learning about themselves, and seeing that they know somebody cares about them.
I think in our churches here in America, we've been making a great error, and we've been ministering basically to ourselves, but the vision of Christ includes people. God loves people. Jesus loves people. In fact, if he said, we can't love our neighbor, how can we love him? And so many times in the church, we've got to the point where we loved each other. We loved each other into the kingdom, and then we stopped there. But in our vision here at East Gadsden, it's about the people.
The congregation and the administrative board voted for this church to live. We have a choice. We can keep floating along and close the doors, or we can be proactive. We've talked about it for years, and this year it's happening. It is happening as we speak. We know God approves that plan, and we hope that we can be spiritual enough to listen and to get out of his way and to do what he commands us to do. And we chose to live. And I think that's a very important thing.
Hi, I'm Kathy Williams, and I worship at Christ Central Church. We all have great gifts and talents, and the opportunities are priceless here to make a change in the lives of these children, to give them the hope that we have, to love as Christ loved and to serve as Christ served.
I'm Callie Seahorn. I'm part of the visioning team at East Gadsden United Methodist Church. Working with children is my God-given talent. It's my passion. I want to be involved in the lives of these children in our neighborhood. I want to be the one who introduces new and unusual experiences that will have a lasting impact on their lives.
So thankful that we've been able to be a part of this transition, because 11 months ago, if you'd have told me that we were going to be starting a new congregation there in an after-school program, I would have thought you were crazy.
I've always felt that there's something big, something awesome going to happen there, and I want to be a part of it. And I've always felt that God wants me to be a part of it. The reality is, our church has failed to love our neighbors. But the vision is to create an appropriate environment within the church and to be able to cross over those racial barriers. Because, you know, the bottom line is, Jesus doesn't care what color you are, why should we? These children need an example of Christ, and I believe our program is just that. My dream is that when these children have grown into adults, they will recall that East Gadsden United Methodist Church is where they first learned about Jesus. When these kids first started coming, they came for free food and basketball. And now, they're excited to hear the message.